Want to bring in Rudy Giuliani now. President Trump's attorney spent years federal prosecutor in Manhattan before becoming the mayor of this great city. And nice to see you and good morning.
How are you?
The Metropolitan Correctional Center, known as the MCC, Lower Manhattan. You know it well.
I saw it being built.
You saw it being built.
Sure, it's connected to the U.S. Attorney's Office.
How would you explain it to viewers? How would you describe it?
Well,
what's happening on a Saturday night inside this jail?
So it's a jail rather than a prison. So people don't know the distinction between it. The jail is a place you hold people when they're awaiting trial. A prison is where you put them when they finally get sentenced. Those are more permanent places. Frankly, they're easier to handle, prisons. Jails are harder because they're very transient. Population in, out every day. However, there's absolutely no excuse for this. What happened here, to me, is mind-boggling. It's impossible to happen. It's a relatively small facility. This isn't Rikers Island, which is, 15,000 people in virtually a city with many, many different buildings.
On its own island.
Yeah, one building. Almost everything is within view, if you want it to be, of the guards. This argument over whether he was on suicide watch or not is, silly, because if he wasn't on suicide watch, he should have been on watch. The guy was a high-risk prisoner, wasn't he? I mean, he's a guy that there are probably 50 very important people that have a motive to kill him. We don't even know who they are. I'm not alleging that any of the people named, it's true. But we know there are some people that are in a lot of trouble because of Epstein. They know who they are. So there are people have, there's tremendous motive to kill him.
It's almost like an Agatha Christie.
Whether they want to kill him or not, prisoners don't like him. Right? He's alleged to be maybe, the most notorious child predator of our generation. Prisoners are strange. Perverts, they don't like. So they'll kill a pervert just to kill a pervert. Second, he's a possible rat also. There's a lot of talk about him testifying. I believe you have to do that. That's good for the government. They believe you're a rat when you do it. So you got three strong reasons why this man may be done in. He might commit suicide. He apparently attempted it. Or he was attacked. That threat still remained even after a week. And the third one is maybe a prisoner on his own is just going to take him out like they did with Whitey Bulger. I do not understand how anyone can explain not having him under 24-hour surveillance or not checking the camera constantly. So that leads to all the speculation that we all are upset about.
Is there a camera?
But we created the vacuum for that crazy speculation.
Is there a camera?
Of course there's a camera. It wasn't working, they said. It wasn't working. The camera wasn't working. There's a camera in every part of a prison. Every single telephone call in and out of prison is listened to. Prisons are prisons. Now, the federal prison system, I used to be in charge of it in the Reagan administration, and then I worked with it for 15 years as an assistant U.S. attorney, U.S. attorney. The federal prison system is the best in the world. When Norman Carlson ran it, he was the head of it all the time I was there. It was the model. It's hard for me to believe this could possibly happen.
How about this then, Mayor, on screen? This is what we believe to be the case here. Not placed on suicide watch, not checked for several hours, no cellmate at time of death. One guard was a substitute, guards working maximum overtime shifts that way.
The last two are no excuse. Whether he's a substitute or not, he has eyes. Epstein was not a tough guy to contain. I mean, if you saw him taking a sheet, anybody of reasonable build or courage could take him down, and he could call for help right away. So whether he was a substitute or not, who cares? That's silly. They were overworked. Okay, but this is the prime target prisoner in that prison. Name the one that's in more jeopardy than this guy. And okay, we don't have great sympathy for him because he's a sexual predator, allegedly. But the guy would have been a treasure trove of very important, valuable information about the truth or the falsity. And I happen to believe there's both in these stories that are coming out. There are people that are probably named that did it, and there are people that are probably named that are being horribly defamed. Only he knows it. And he's the kind of guy where you probably couldn't let him out of jail, or maybe you could give him a little light at the end of the tunnel. But maybe you could have appealed to his making it right by telling the truth. Who knows?
You make sure he lives. July 23rd was the incident where he was found in his cell. He either tried to harm himself, or as you point out, perhaps the cellmate was in it to harm him. He was taken off suicide watch a week later, so that's August 1st. He's found dead in his cell on August 10th.
I don't understand. I never heard of the policy you're only on suicide watch for a week. You're on suicide watch for as long as you have the conditions that indicate you might commit suicide. The conditions yesterday or the day before were no different on the day that he attempted suicide, meaning he was in prison. He was looking at a life in prison. He was looking at going from this prison to probably even more rigid conditions of confinement. Tough guy to go to a prison, right? You send this guy into a prison population, they're going to, you know what's going to happen to him, right? So what is he going to do? He's either going to get a terrible death in prison, or he's going to be locked up in solitary confinement for the rest of his life.
But with
that condition remained on the day that they took off the suicide watch. Are they crazy?
With regard,
I mean, you got to be nuts.
With suicide watch is a conversation. I have a conversation with you. I'm going to gauge your mental state. That's what they are charged with doing inside this jail. So they clearly had conversations with him and his lawyers, likely over a period of 10 days, and said it's okay to go ahead and take you off watch.
1 week, 10 days.
I understand suicide watch. The sheets you were given are made of paper. Is that true?
That is true. Yes.
Okay. And he hung himself with a bed sheet.
Right. Never should have had bed sheets.
But
we can go beyond that. His room should have been guarded because there was every possibility some prisoner that got loose would get in there and stab him, kill him, choke him, make it look like he was hung. The desire to kill him in that prison was very high. He was the guy they most wanted to kill in that prison. Of all the prisoners there, he's the guy one of those prisoners would love to kill just to have that on his creds. And probably nobody would turn him in if he did it. So he would feel a certain sense of protection. You got to understand a prison. Of course they understand it. The people running that understand it. It would be very hard for me to understand the explanation as to why this man wasn't watched 24 hours a day.
Three more questions quickly. Could it be simple negligence?
Yes, it could be simple negligence.
Do you believe that Epstein killed Epstein?
I don't know. I think I have to step back and say I don't know what to believe. I think the attorney general gives me great confidence that there's going to be one heck of an investigation. That guy is tough as nails. And that's the saving grace here, because this has to come all out. Whatever it is, all the facts have to come out. Otherwise, these conspiracy theories are going to run wild.
And you were cautious on that yesterday.
I am. I'm very cautious.
You made a public statement on Twitter. You said, let's hold your fire and let's wait for the facts.
Well, I think it's ridiculous to start speculating that this person had a motive and that person had a motive and that. People, everybody has motives. That doesn't mean they would participate in the killing. That's ridiculous to try to extrapolate like that. The fact is, the man was found in his cell. It now looks like something was put around his neck, either by him or someone else, and he was hung. Now we got to take the next step. There are three possibilities, right? He hung himself. A prisoner, just for that, what happens in prison, killed him, because he's the kind of guy they kill in prison. Or number three, somebody from the outside organized this. And the guards either did it negligently, or we could have a umbrella situation.
When do you believe we get those answers? When is that?
Probably going to take a couple weeks.
It's
a tough investigation, but a short one. It's nothing like the other investigation he's conducting of interference in the election, which has many pieces to it. One place, small real estate. A lot of big questions.
Only a few players.
Abe Relis was the guy that jumped out of the window of the, I think it was the Blue Moon Hotel in Staten Island the night before he was going to testify against Al Anastasia, and the two police officers weren't watching. And then there was a headline that said, "The canary can sing, but he can't fly."
Wow. Thank you, Mayor. Rudy Giuliani,
history.
We'll wait
just
for
a little history.
Thank you. Thanks for coming in.
All right, take care.